So I just push the air out and I don't see any more bubbles coming out. So now I'm going to pull the piston back on this line while it's down submerged in the fluid. Okay, I see the bottom of the piston now. So that one is done. Put a little bit of fluid in here, doesn't take much. This will only take 5 or 6 drops. The fluid sort of squeezes out as you turn it in there. Hopefully not a lot of air gets in. Here's a quick test. Is air compresses very easily. The hydraulic fluid of course does not. So if you push on it and it really moves, then you've got air in your system. These don't move at all, which tells me there's probably no air in the system, or at least minimal. Time for reassembly. I have wiped off my marks and while I was cleaning everything up to show me which point to connect this back up. However, I remember where the zip tie was here, and so I know it's going to go like this. This corner goes to this corner. Now, this slide into here like this, right up against there. The screw drive, I'm going to loosen it up some so we're not pushing against the pistons when I put it all back together. Or maybe it needs to be all the way in. So then I'm going to line this up straight across. I'll do the same with the motor to put it all back together. Gotta put the bearing down in here. Those don't quite line up. I think I possibly put too much hydraulic fluid in, so I had to loosen this up a little bit to push it out. So what I'll end up doing is bleeding some out of here. I'll put this as the highest point, then all the air should go up, and I will bleed it out from up here a little bit of fluid so that I can close this back down properly. Ready to put it back together. You want to make sure that your rams are up so that you can grab a hold of them on the top of the deck lid and turn them to install the spoiler. Make sure you can spin them around too within the housing. That'll make it a lot easier if you know you can do that. No better time to clean and wax underneath of your spoiler than when you have the spoiler off. So clean it thoroughly, give it a good coat of wax, and you'll end up with a nice shiny area between the spoiler and the car. Clean hands plus gloves. Clean, fresh gloves.